It was a pretty long day. We got the filter completed, set up and running. And before we jump into that, I was hoping that you guys wouldn't mind if we fed all the fish here first.
I guess we should feed Frank first.
Frank's got his mouth full. Francine takes it and runs.
Aw, look at her there.
Now it's actually getting kind of late out here in the gallery, so some of the tanks are programmed to be off right now, so some we won't see, but I'll show you what it's like to feed one of my favorite tanks.
Okay, this is gonna be the Asian arowana.
Calm down, you guys.
Get it, guys. So the lights are almost completely off here in the 2,000 gallon. And I actually used some of the water here to fill up the new filter a few hours ago, but these guys are all kind of hungry. Next tank.
I guess we'll do the exodons next.
You guys wanna see?
You gotta be kind of quick here. I got a lot I gotta do still. Discus, same thing. This food is actually intended for the discus, but the exodons enjoy it as well.
I guess the Waru can have some brine shrimp.
Look, this piece got stuck on the wave maker here, and as it defrosts, it's blowing it throughout the tank. Perfect distribution. Oh! Did I just see a pleco? Everybody's been asking about where the plecos are at. There is one behind this piece of wood. I just seen his tail. There he is. You see him? Hey, told you, they're still here.
Tropius can get some little pellets. More pellets for these guys.
More pellets for these guys. The lights are out for this tank for the night. I don't intend to turn them back on, but just look at the food. There they go. 375 is going to get a pretty big handful of pellets and food sticks as well. This light's almost out for the entire night though, so it's going to be tough to see into it. I don't know if you guys will be able to see that. They're eating. Alright folks, that's it for a little bit of a feeding. Hope yous didn't mind that before we start the main video. Hope yous enjoyed the actual video though. Here we go. So yesterday you guys will have watched that we built the barrel filter. I'll bring those up to speed that didn't see it yet. Essentially, it's a 55 gallon black barrel. Inside of it, a couple of laundry baskets. The top one is the pre-filter in which we drilled some holes in it for water to flow through. Polyester filling on top to filter out the fine particles. Below it, another large basket. This one's a little different though. It's several times the height. It's filled with plastic bio balls, and below it, half of the basket's actually filled with a highly porous ceramic media. Both are biological media. The way this is going to work is water's gonna flow through the top basket, be pre-filtered here, and then flow through all of the biological media, exiting out the sides. At the bottom, I'm gonna put the pump and it's just gonna return right out the top. We use very little tools in order to do this. I only had to use one tool, which was a drill, to drill out the bottom here. The buckets, the baskets, cost $50 total, so this isn't a bad filter. Again, we're trying to build a filter to run the 375 gallon aquarium for as little money as possible. We're gonna take out the old Bashy aquarium sump, and we're gonna use that on the saltwater sump inside, or the saltwater aquarium inside. Right now, I'm currently draining it, and then we gotta move all of this out of the way. The goal for today's video is ultimately get everything out of there, get this barrel installed and up and running.
Whew, sump is drained. Got all the equipment out. We're pretty much good to go now.
We're gonna take it outside. I'm gonna rinse it off before it goes in the house, because remember, this is getting used on the saltwater aquarium.
So this one's made of acrylic, so much lighter than a regular tank.
gallons. I wish all tanks weighed as little as this big. Now let's go get some work done. I guess the next thing here is get the racking system completely out of here. That'll be simple. All of it's just kind of clicked together. Watch. I don't know if that's actually... That one's in there good. I'm gonna need a hammer. Alright, got everything moved out of the way. Have to clean up and do a shop back a little bit, but get the filter in here now. Look how much room we have for activities, Gary.
Oh, I like karate. So that replaced that big thing?
Sure.
Beautiful. Much more space. Very simple. To maintain easy access. I love it. All right, so the first thing I gotta do here is fill this barrel up to an operating level. So check this out. You see the bio balls over on this side. It kind of surrounds the entire area by about, I don't know, up to the first ring. So that's about 12, 24, yeah, that's about 12 inches of bio balls all the way around it. And then we have several in here. And then of course this is jam packed with a ceramic media, but all I want to make sure is if these are going to float or not. We'll see what happens. I know that it might seem like a waste, but if water exits throughout the sides, it still has to pass through these before being pumped to the aquarium. So I'm just trying to get full contact with the media. We'll see what happens. Now, as we're filling this up to operating level, you can see now that these are going to float. You know, maybe you can't see it, but I'm already thinking of a change I want to do, believe it or not. I'm not sure if this basket is going to work out for me long term. I think what I might end up doing is eventually replacing this basket with a solid sided basket that's a little bit bigger and drill holes through the bottom so the water is forced to go through all the media. We're going to try it like this for a little while, see how things go, but ultimately we need to control the path of the water. I hope that what doesn't happen is it just goes through some of the media and out the sides, but you know, for very little planning and very little money, I think it's going to be fine for at least a while. Well, it works. Of course, well, nothing's leaking. It's actually pretty quiet. Once we get... There's so many changes I want to make and adjustments. Of course, this is going to be perfect. This is day one. Within 20 minutes, came up with the idea. Grabbed these barrels or grabbed these baskets and ran with it. If you're following along and you want to build something like this, just wait until I'm done. I'll make some final adjusting. I think I'm going to change out that bottom basket. I'm really not liking it. I think I want to go with something slightly bigger and with solid size, just to solid sides to control the flow of the water. I also want to make sure we get these lids on and the plumbing goes through it so it's silent. Open up one of the vents and it'll be perfect. But right now, I really like it. It's going to be much cleaner. I think I'm going to switch to a lot of hard plumbing. Clean up all the mess out here, get started on this filter as well. Again, we're gonna build a platform, 2 55-gallon barrels connected. I'll show you how I do all that. And I think you guys are gonna like it. Also need to go ahead and give the 375 a good cleaning. Maybe we'll do that in the near future, show you guys how I tackle this tank with all of these fish in it. Oh, look what it is. Oh, Stein just took off. That tank definitely is in for a, needs a good cleaning here shortly, but if you guys want to see that, let me know in the comment section below. If there's anything else you want to see me do out here, let me know that as well. Huge shout out to Gary for coming along and helping me out today. I'll leave a link to both his and my Instagram in the description below so you guys can follow along there as well. A few more projects that I want to tackle out here, and a bunch of other ideas for videos. If you have any suggestions, once again, leave them in the comment section below. If you're not subscribed to this channel yet and you enjoy these types of aquarium videos. I can't guarantee I'll continue to make these filters, but I guarantee I'll continue to make aquarium-related videos that I hope you enjoy.